you know, being asked about genetics of the grasses, and I would heard, I'm going to speak about my herd, and a lot of my neighbors got their starting from us anyway. The folks that I deal with, they got help from me, or their daddy got help from my daddy, or their granddaddy got help from my granddaddy. When my great-granddaddy came there, he also brought a little herd of crop of cattle. And that was the origin of the cattle we have now. We've never brought a female onto the farm, I don't believe, since he did in 1866. Now, on the bull side, my father and I both were guilty of the flavor of the month club with bulls. I see him do it and I do it, go somewhere and say, I know, say the bull, like, how much is that bull? He said, what if I take all of them, how much of them? You know, it's more some new genetics. But if you rode by my farm at 60 miles an hour, it looks like an Angus herd. I got 36. Every bull I got now is a registered Angus bull. You know, I like short, thick, and yes, by grasses, I'm telling you about that, and they got some mixed in. Our grasses are in the summer. It's a warm season perennial. We've got three Bahias, four Bermudas, Dallas grass, little Johnson grass, some other thing. In the winter, it's a cool season annuals, wheat, oats, rye, and clover on the seed motion. And when you ask about and I might step on somebody's toes here, but do just excuse me. But, you know, when you talk to a seed stock dealer, it's all about genetics. And when you talk to a forage specialist, it's all about the grass. When you talk to a medicine salesman, vaccine, it's all about the vaccine. You know, my daddy said, if all you got is a hammer, everything looks like a nail. And the truth is, what I do is a very, very holistic occupation. And I got to pay attention to all of it. And none of it is uber important. It's all uber important. So, you know, I really get frustrated when I hear people say, this is the only genetics you can use, and this is the only grass you can use.